Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. I'm Jessica Stansberry, and I am here to teach you all things digital and content marketing so that you can run a better business. So today's topic I've actually talked about before, just not on my channel. I did a guest post and guest YouTube video for the Think Creative Collective blog and YouTube channel a couple of months ago about this subject, but I really wanted to bring it to you guys here on this channel and make another video for you so that you could really see the full potential of what I'm talking about, and that is Butler for Trello. Now, Butler for Trello is a little bit hard to explain, but it's almost like a plugin or an app for Trello, but it has so many capabilities that it is mind-blowing. Like, literally mind-blowing. I love Butler for Trello. I use it to do things like when a blog post is due on my blog board, bring it over and put it on our calendar board for that week so we know that it's going live that week. Or when something is done and we check it off, remove it so we don't have to look at it anymore. A lot of the negative remarks I hear about Trello are generally around their confusion and inability to move things from one board to another and all of that jazz. But Butler kind of handles that for you. Now, Butler's a free service, and you can literally just go to butlerfortrello.com and see, you know, kind of what it does and read the help Trello board and all the things. Now, there's actually a Butler power-up inside of Trello, but that's not what I recommend. I actually recommend installing the Butler bot on your Trello boards and in your Trello account. So I'm going to show you how to install Butler for Trello and how to use it in its basic form so that you can see how you can use this in your business. All right, let's go.
Okay, so Butler for Trello can be found in several different places, but you can totally go to butlerfortrello.com. Or click on the link that I've provided in the post, and it'll take you straight to this Trello board where they have all of their stuff. The most important things here are you can sort of read through like their stuff, so their terms of service, their monthly newsletter, paid membership, all of that jazz. But what I really want you to focus on when you're here are the instructions and documentation. And most importantly, I want you to focus on how to use Butler in the command builder. So both of those things are really, you know, really cool. So basically what happens is you will open up this how to use Butler, and you will use this to invite Butler to your board. So I'm just going to open that. And I synced it up with my Trello before, and I can invite Butler to specific boards. I don't need him, if we're calling him a him, on all my boards, so I've only invited him to certain boards. Now, when that happens, Butler will have a column just like this and will have instructions. And those instructions can seem a little bit crazy, but I really want you to focus hard on this command builder, which you can find in the instructions card when Butler is added to your board, or in this Trello board here, and you can just click. So the command builder, this is where the gold happens. So what happens is you set up commands. So let's say I want to, when a card is added to one board, I want to add it to another board. So let's say I have a blog post workflow board, and I have a webinar board, and I have a marketing board, and I have a this board and a that board, and I basically just want all of those boards to sync up to one master calendar. This is where this would come in handy. So I'll come in here and I will select my trigger. So what I'll do is when a card is added to the board, and what I can do here is tell it, when a card is added to the board, so because you will be putting this specific action on that specific board, you don't have to like pick what the board is. Okay. So when a card is added to the board, now that's my trigger. So I'm done with this column. I need to go to actions. So create a card in another board. So what I want to do here is I want to do this. Find this little option here, and you can scroll through all of these and figure out what works best for you. There are a ton of options, but I want to copy the card to the list, you know, whatever. So let's say to the list, future on my board calendar. Hey, Jessica. All right. So now it has built a command for me down here. Something I want to point out really quickly is that you need to make sure the list and the board are written exactly as they are in yours. So this is my calendar, hey Jessica, which is exactly how I wrote it here. And I have a future, but if you'll notice, it's a capital F. So if I actually want that to fire and work, that list needs to have a capital F as well. Okay, so all you have to do is copy this, and you can click the little button here or just highlight it and copy it. Now, let's say I wanted anytime I add a card to my, let's see, blog workflow board, then I want it added to Hey Jessica. So you come under Butler and you just create a new card. You paste that command in and as the card title and you hit enter. Now, Butler will sort of check on it and do some work. If you get a big check mark and an understood, you've done it right. Okay? So now, if I were to go in and add a card here, then it will add it to future on my board calendar, Hey Jessica. So, let's try this out. All right, so there's my card I just created. Here's an idea. Now I want to go back to my calendar, Hey Jessica, and go into my future column. And it does sometimes take a minute, so I'm going to refresh and see if that will pull it in. Okay, so there it is. So we wasted a little time there and let it, I don't know, maybe a minute or so go by. And now this card has been copied onto the future column in this board. So this can come in handy in so many ways. Like I mentioned in the intro part of this video, for me, something that I use is I have tasks for this week. And I have tasks for next week, and then I have Monday through Friday set up. So what I have set up is this calendar is my master calendar, so I have any webinars, any marketing, all of that in here. And if it's scheduled for more than a week out, it's in this future column. And so I have Butler set up to say when it's 8 to 14 days out, add it here. When it's less than 7 days out, add it here. When we start a new week, Brittany, my assistant, will go in and take these cards and move them over to the day they need to be done. So it works really well and it's really awesome. And I hope that you guys can use Butler to make your Trello better.
Yes! Isn't that awesome? I just love Butler for Trello is one of my favorite things. And it makes Trello even more awesome. Like, I thought the system was awesome before, but it's like really awesome now. So if you want a bank of all of my Trello boards I've ever released to the public, click the link below this video and go check those out. You can grab all of them, copy them, and use them in your business however you want to use them. And before you go, please hit subscribe. It's important to me. Like I want to know that you're gonna see the things I put out because I'm planning out content like a wild woman, and if nobody's gonna see it, I'm gonna be really sad and I'm gonna cry and it's not gonna be pretty because I'm an ugly crier. So hit subscribe and come back next time for more system and content marketing strategy tips. Bye y'all.